Well, I got the refractometer working, so if you want to geek out for a minute and listen, I'll explain to you how this works. Now, remember, I was concerned about how much salt was in the water. I had just added salt to the water based on the instructions, so it's a half a cup per gallon of water. But you can't count on that in the long run because of evaporation, and there's a lot of surface area here. So I know I've been losing water every day, but it's real cool in here, and it didn't seem like I was really losing that much. I mean, I couldn't see the level dropping on the table here that much. And I was adding fresh water, trying to guess, you know, to compensate for the loss of water. Because of course, when the water evaporates, the salt doesn't go with it. So as the water leaves the table and just enters into the air, it leaves the water saltier and saltier. So you need to compensate for that by adding fresh water, which I've been doing, but not enough. Because when I tested this with the refractometer, it was significantly higher, more salinity than it should be. So I'll kind of explain how that works. So the ocean out here in the Pacific Ocean, in this part of the world, should be about 1.022 on the specific gravity meter, so to speak, or relative density. That's another way of saying that, which I think makes more sense. So relative density, or specific gravity, has to do with the density per unit of volume of the liquid, in this case, salt water, relative to the same amount of fresh water. So fresh water for the scale is set at 1. What we want is 1.022. You don't need to worry about exactly how those numbers come about. It's just relative. Well, when I measured this out, or I looked through the refractometer here, it came out to 1.025, which doesn't sound like a big difference, but it took 3 full gallons of water, fresh water, to bring it back down where it wanted at 1.022. So I'm really glad I got this thing, because I was off on my estimations of salt. But what that shows us, though, is that these guys can handle some pretty salty water, which is, like I was saying, they're native all the way down into Baja, where the water's going to be significantly saltier. So they can handle a range of salt for sure, but I don't want to stress them out. So I'm glad I got the refractometer, and we got that little problem fixed. So everything's cool now. They're looking good. You know, some of them, like that one, I think there's a few that aren't too lively, and I think those are the ones I brought home from the store that have been here and there, and they're just beat up, but they're still alive. I've only lost, out of those 24 that I brought home from the store, I think 3 have actually taken out that were completely dead. So there's 5 or 6 that don't look very good, but they're still alive, and we'll see what happens. Now, this concept of the density of water is really important for a lot of reasons besides just getting the right amount of salt in the water. You know, that's what makes ice float. Okay, so the fresh water is its most dense at 39.2 degrees, right? So as the temperature of the water drops below 39.2, it actually becomes less dense. And when it freezes, it's ice, and it will float on water. And that's why it floats. And that's why we float on salt water a lot better than we do on fresh water. And it's also why lakes turn over in the spring and the fall. That change in the temperature becomes, the water's becoming less dense and more dense. And that's causing the turnover in the lake and moves the fish around, positions the fish, positions the food. So really important for fishermen. So I've got this thing now. So now we're gonna know that I can always keep the salt water, the right amount of saltiness, which is a big deal, I think. So it's looking good. I appreciate all the comments and the interest in this. You know, it's kind of fun. And a lot of great ideas. So I'll be doing some more things for you. You know, maybe you can share this with some people, maybe have some experience with this or are interested, and that would be great. I think maybe I need to build another table. I've got some crawdads coming for the store, and I'm gonna put together something similar to this so I can show you guys how I made this. And I have an idea for a good inexpensive way to keep these, you know, just for the guy who's wants to use sand shrimp for fishing, you buy a couple dozen and you want to keep them live longer, maybe I'll go over how I think that might work out pretty well and experiment with that a little bit. So, it's all good in the hood here. So we'll talk to you later.